Hi, Peer Leadership Council here. My name is Ruth, one of the PLC execs. And today I'm going to take you on a comprehensive virtual 2020 Elgin school tour.
Right now, I'm entering through the main entrance, but don't forget, the entrance you use depends on where your classrooms are. When you walk in, always sanitize your hands, and if you forget your mask, you can ask the office for one. From the main entrance, the first thing you see is the office and the science wing. Let's go take a look at the science hall. You'll have biology, chemistry, physics, and geology classes. As you can see, I'm at the main hall. Here's the LST room. There'll always be someone here in the LST to help you in terms of academics if you're struggling.
This. Oh no, this is the art room.
And across from it are the tech ed classes. Many of y'all will be spending a lot of your time here with the many projects each of these classes have, from furniture and cabinetry, automotive power technology, to art metal and jewelry. This is the counseling office. On this board are the sites you can use to make appointments. Who your all-fac counselor is depends on what your last name is. Miss Kim is A to G, Miss Hogan is H to LI, Miss Hundo is LIA to SA, and Miss Gill is SC to Z. Behind is the ELL room. Some of you guys might have class here, learning about Canadian culture and the language. Just to their left are the washrooms. Up next is Home Ec, Computers, and Business Hall, where your career goals can be realized. If you enjoy cooking or baking, pastry art is the way to go. Into graphic design? Join the yearbook making team. See that sign? Guitar is one of the options you can choose for your art credits, and let me tell you, it's one of the best choices there is. Through these doors, we're entering the cafeteria, where you usually buy and eat lunch. But for this year, the cafeteria is closed. Make sure you're aware of the policy, 2 people per table and masks on when you're not eating. This door leads to the career center. Any questions you might have about volunteering or post-secondary can be answered either by Ms. Spencer, Ms. Moyer, or Ms. Jansen. Further down here, you arrive at the theater, where all of Elgin's big productions such as Clue take place. Across, you'll see the 2 washrooms in this part of the school. And going straight, you will see many English and social classrooms. And through those doors, you'll go out to the portables. We have arrived at the site of the school where all the 4 portables are. Depending on your schedule, you might have a class here. FYI, you can find the portable number on the side of the stairs. In addition to the adorable seagull, we also have our gravel field where we gather for emergencies as a school, and the grass field where many sports used to take place, such as rugby and soccer. Rounding the corner, we find ourselves in the other big 2-way entrance. Once again, I'm going through the back door specifically for the tour, but please follow COVID protocols and enter through the door closest to your classroom. And of course, sanitize accordingly. If you ever find yourself with some time to spare, come down to this hallway and look at the awards that orcas have received. And yes, this door leads to our big gym. Going back to the main hall, we have the small gym. The athletics department office is on the right, as well as the change rooms, which are closed this year due to the pandemic. Right here, we have the band room. In band, we work together to play good music and prepare for concerts. However, as we all know, the events are on hold due to the pandemic. In a normal year, the band will travel to Disneyland, Whistler, Hawaii, Japan, and other places for special performances and workshops. Now we have returned to the cafeteria. If we come this way, we find ourselves in another entrance to the big gym and the weight room. Let's walk this way and take the main stairs. On the wall, we have our main scholarship bulletin board. Around the corner are another few science and math classes. This is where the heart dissections happen, so make sure you do biology if you're interested. This hallway is where we can find the BASIS program. Here is the language hallway. If you're not into French, there's always the option to take Spanish in grade 9. Join us on our trips around the world and learn about different cultures while having fun. Down this way will take us to the library. Here, you can print your papers out, check out books, and use a computer. Make sure you follow the arrows when entering and leaving the library.
Ta-da! Exit.
The last hall on the second floor is the English and Socials Hall, and we have our main attraction, the washrooms. This is the only washroom on the second floor. And reminder, all staircases at the end of the hallways are one way, so make sure you're going the right way. Because of this, I'm going to take the staircase beside the washroom instead of this staircase at the end of the hallway, which is one way up. Out these doors and around the corner is the courtyard, where you can enjoy the sunny weather, if there are any, and get some fresh air between classes.
A big thanks to everyone who's made it to the end of the video with me. Now that you know our school a little bit better, please make sure to complete your scavenger hunt questions for a chance to win a $10 Starbucks gift card. The last chance to hand it in is December 3rd. We look forward to seeing your answers. Hi, Peer Leadership Council here. I'm Ruth, one of the execs of PLC. And today I'm gonna take you on to a comprehensive 2020 Elgin tour.
See if that small gym is okay.
Kind of mean.
Look, it's a basketball.
Now that you know our school a little bit better, make sure to complete your scavenger hunt questions for a chance to win a $10 gift Starbucks.